Welcome to our first session of Myofascial Release. You might need a tennis ball, a ping-pong ball made up of two tennis balls. So if you have two tennis balls, you do not have a ping-pong ball. You're tied in a sock like this. Now once you have your prop ready, make sure you have a hard ground. It can be made up of books, it doesn't have to be gloves. And a soft pad, like a pillow to sit on. Once you're set, let's come to the center of your mat. It might not be mat, it can be just on the ground or a soft mattress. Now what you need is for myofascial release, on every part of our body, you'll be rolling for about 30 seconds up to 2 minutes. So for today, you'll be rolling 1 minute. So I'll go into my interval time and click on this. So when you hear the ding, the beep, whatever sound it is, it means that 1 minute is up. Now we will work it from our fingertips all the way to our shoulder. So for today, we'll be doing the whole length of our arms, including our shoulder muscles. Now once you have your prop, a peanut ball is good. Otherwise, make your own shape of peanut ball. Now if you do not have a peanut ball, one tennis ball will also work, but it's just harder to balance. Your ball may just bounce off and you might need to pick it up. Now if you do not have a ball, you will use a block or something that is not too hard or too soft. So let's say if you're using a block, you do not have instead of rolling like this, what you do is you'll be doing into different sections on the edges of the block. So you will be moving your hands, the block doesn't move, but you'll be moving your hands up and down to ease up the tension inside your arms, fingertips. So for today, you'll be doing our whole arm, including shoulders. Now, so we will start. Now we will be working on first our fingertips. Now I use a higher ground so it will be easier so you don't have to lean too far. Now for fingertips, we will use a single ball, tennis ball, or the edge of your peanut ball. So what we'll do is now you'll roll the back of our hands. So back of your hands. Doesn't matter which arm you start first. Later on, you just move on to the other hand. Make sure you roll into all five fingers. Your index fingers, middle finger. So, when will you use your finger muscles? It's when you do your arm balance, which you use your muscles to squeeze into the mat. Now, palms. So I'm doing my right hand. So front part of your hand. Now for myofascial release is to release tension. Should you roll your fingers? Now, your wrist, right wrist. Now, if you tend to forget like which part you've done, which part you didn't, it will be good to just always right, left, right, left. So it will be good to roll in circular motion. And rolling out the edges of your wrist. Now this outside of the ribs is quite delicate. It is your talons. Now this is the part in which usually if you're resting, this is the point. Now right side, this palm, back of your wrist. So there's no right or wrong to roll in different method or different angle. As long as you roll into the parts, it's alright. Now the other hand, back side of your wrist. You can use the other hand to add more weight, to have more tension. Now if you're rolling, let's say at home, at your own free time, you might just want to set the timer 2 minutes, but you can ignore that 2 minutes if you find that you need more time, especially parts which are more tender and soft. Or sometimes you might take longer time to ease into it. You can play some music, whatever that ease you at that particular moment. Make sure the inside, palm side. And we are done with our wrist to fingers. Now next part, what we will be doing is on this front part, which is the posterior part of your forearm, we will need peanut butter. Now if you are taller, you might need 3 blocks so that it will be easy to roll. So you do not have to round your back, so you might be creating tension in your back. So your wrist, now your forearm is quite long, you can split it into 2 blocks. So I'm rolling my right hand on the bottom section. Now make sure you roll the top part. Usually I stick my hands and do a section of hands here. So I'm not going to spend so much energy in rolling. So this is the time where you're going to roll slow. So I'm using a peanut ball for my forearm. You can use your tennis ball, your dual tennis ball. If you're using a single solo ball, you just need to make sure it doesn't roll out. It might bounce off. Just pick your ball out and continue rolling. It's the same. And this time, still on the right side, on the inner part of your forearm. I use my other hand to add weight. On the section closer towards your elbow. Switch on left side, on the outside, closer towards your wrist. So when do I usually do this rolling? It's when, let's say if I go overseas, I won't be able to engage your muscle and you are tired. This is when I train goals. Because in Singapore, usually you can just go to any muscle power to just massage your muscles as the same. Except this is your own energy, your own technique. So overseas timing, this is when it's evening. Or let's say when I'm on the bottom part. Or let's say when I'm in a plane. Or let's say when I'm in a lecture. I mean like a lecture that obviously won't be so obvious rolling like that. I'll be doing a small dance. I mean like it makes me don't fall asleep during lectures, right? So you have sensation in your body that you won't fall asleep. Or sometimes I did the goal before I start teaching. I actually go to classes much earlier. So what do? I either like stretching or just rolling. until the next student come in to the class. So I'm used to be there. First person always in the studio. Now on the inside of your wrist, not wrist, forearm, closer towards your wrist. I'm always the one that is very early to class, doing random things in the studio. Later on, when we are doing off our upper arms, it will be much harder to roll. But we will get past. Now, working on our upper arms, you split it into four different sections. So one facing the front, the other outside, and one, so three parts, not four. On the insides of your arm. So when you extend, this will be a hollow. So now you roll this front part. So how to roll this front part? You need to lie on a firm ground. Either hard or firm ground. If it's not mattress, it will be hard to roll. So I will bring my arms on ground like this, and I will roll section by section. Now, your upper arm is more tender, you might feel more sore in this because the muscle group then is bigger. So if you ache more, whichever muscle is bigger, that is when you will ache more. Now, on the outside, not on the outside, later on, you will go to the wall. I'll be using this wall. So let's say if this is the wall, you press like this. So your peanut ball, your press up. So this is the wall. And you roll your body up. So you move on to the wall. Now the timing is just as a guideline. You don't have to roll exactly like it. So I will roll this front. This is our biceps. Just so we roll our inner part, it's our triceps, not biceps. Feel free to switch the location. So earlier on, I roll closer to my elbow, now on the bottom. So this is your shoulder girdle. you'll be leaning against the wall and you'll be rolling your arms up and down. Switch your ankle. One leg. Now once you press the wall, you'll rotate your torso 90 degrees and you'll roll up and down. Or whichever method that suits you. Now if you try to roll the whole thing, your thighs will ache because you're squatting up and down too much. But if you want some leg roll out, feel free to do so. So today is our so-called rest day. We will not want to activate so much muscles as much as you can. So in your daily practice, now you'll be rolling on the other side, inside or ground. Now if you find that the ground is too low, you can use a clock. Let that roll. So whenever in your practice, you always have rest day. Now rest day means you will not activate muscles. Feel free to do myofascial release or in poses if you can't stand up doing anything on everything. Make sure you switch towards the front part so both parts split into 10 cm. It will be easier to roll. So I'm on the inner part. This is triceps, the part that we put our knee on in unbalance. Now moving to the wall, outside. You can just sit on ground. If you can roll up, just move your shoulders up and down. Lazy people always have lazy patterns. As long as you roll, it's fine. We'll be working on our shoulders. So this is our shoulder muscles. It's made up of three deltoid muscles. One at the front, one behind, and one from the front linking towards your pecs. So this one will be a single ball. Or this ball where you just use one side and press the ball. Now, some of us might be very soft in this part. You might not want to lean, or you can just add some compression. Just press into it. But if you don't feel anything, now it's close towards your armpits. When you close your arm, there is this pokey part. This is the part which you will place your ball. Now if you want more compression, you place it on a block. One ball, and then press it on like this. And to move, we are putting on compression pads. So stay on. So I'm back to my right side. Can just put the balls on the string part. I usually use compression techniques rather than rolling. Rolling, this is compression because it's hard to roll on shoulders, not on the back. Here, this part. Now, last part, last side, top part. Feel free to lean against the wall. So we are almost ending. This is our last slide. So we have all both our arms linking from our fingers all the way to our shoulder muscles, delta muscles. So feel free to shake your wrists, elbows up and down, rotate shoulders back and forth. You should feel more relief on your arms, but your back might ache from all the rounding and engaging. So what I would like to do is I will rest in 1 minute in a simple back bend. If you have a wheel prop, you can just do a target back bend for about a minute before you exit. Or if you don't have just a block like this, this is not my head, this is my spine. It might be painful if it's unblocked, but sometimes I like that feeling. So I'll press it onto that part and I will just